Welcome to the Redvee TV preview show of Saints away at Warrington Wolves on Saturday. I'm on my own today, so I'll keep it short and sweet. I've replaced Dave with Tom Van Vollenhoven and Paul Wellens. Even though they're not going to say anything, they'll probably make more sense than Dave does. And we'll interrupt a little bit less as well. Hopefully Dave will be back in time for commentary, which will be on Wish FM, and we'll put the links up on the Redvee website for you if you can't make it to the game. Straight into squad news, Justin Holbrook's decided to bring some of the big guns back in, so Louis McCarthy-Scarsbrook, Dom Peyrou and Ryan Morgan come in place of Jack Wellsby, Matty Costello and Aaron Smith. Aaron Smith signed a new deal this week, a year with a year's option, same as Josh Eaves, keeping the hooking options open. And just nice to see some young players coming through and getting the chance with Saints. And Aaron certainly didn't do anything wrong when he played against Catalan a couple of weeks ago. Theo Farge is expected to be fit as well. He's been named in the squad. He was a late dropout last week due to illness, when it was planned that he was going to play nine, and Jake Spedding had to come in, so obviously there's no change there. Spedding hasn't been called up. I think, to be honest, it's showing Justin Holbrook is sticking to his mantra of playing the players when they're fit and not really just leaving them out sick. We've still got a couple of players still to come back in, and you'd imagine the week off will do them well. But it's going to be good to see Ryan Morgan and Dom Peyrou come back in, and you'd imagine Ryan Morgan will start with Matty Costello having been left out. There's no real other option for that right centre position, but it's going to strengthen that right hand side. Matty Costello's done nothing wrong, and he'll go great guns for having those minutes under his belt, and he is the future of the club. But just for now, it's going to be good seeing some older heads, a bit more experience as we're coming to the crunch end to the season. That said, Warrington have also brought back in some big names. They've got Ben Murdoch-Masilla back, Mike Cooper, Chris Hill, Roberts and Brown will probably pair up again at halfback after all missing the Wigan game. And it seems like nobody's really showing the hand and turning around and saying, well, you know what, we're just going to keep things back. I think with all the video that you can watch of games, and with us having played together like against each other a couple of times this season, there's not really too many secrets now. And you can understand why, having the likes of James Bentley in around the squad, who went really well last week, obviously is good for the progression. You've also got to think that, well, you do want your first team firing now. There's four games left of the season. Just run hard, tackle hard, just take your chances. I know you only have to win your last two to be champions, but let's go out there and let's really put on a show and kind of show what we were doing from April, round about March, April time. The other bit of news that's kind of come out of the club today was probably the biggest non-secret, and that's Matty Smith will be leaving us. Just want to put on record, thanks to Matty for everything he's done in his Saints shirt. This is his third stint coming to an end. It's a shame it's not worked out, but that's how sport goes sometimes, that it doesn't work out. And all the best to him wherever he goes. I know there's rumours of a couple of clubs, Catalan being the main one. That wasn't announced on the members email that got sent out today. But all the best, Matty, and thanks for everything you have done in a Saints shirt. I think this third spell, you'll be most remembered for that drop goal against Salford on a great Saints-style comeback. So that's pretty much it from me. I've just got a couple of notices, just because the local clubs are also involved in playoff rugby round about this time. Pilks are at home to Milford Marlins 2:30 down at Ruskin Drive on Saturday if you can't make the Saints game or you just fancy a bit of amateur rugby league. And then you've actually got a St Helens local derby where Thato Heath will take on Haydock at 2:30 at Thato Heath. Thato Heath B are also at home, same time, on pitch 2 against Springview, I think it is. So if you're not coming down to the Saints game, by all means get down to one of the amateur games. And another thing just to mention with regards to Haydock is they have actually got a fundraiser going on. If you go to the Twitter, it's @HaydockOA. there's tickets for sale, so just get in touch with him. It's for a fundraiser for the player Jordan Gibson, who's been called up to the England Lionhearts to go touring. So obviously it's to raise a bit of funds, get him on the plane. And there's prizes to be won there, which include two tickets in a private box, including meal and drinks for the cast game, which is a great prize. So why not get yourself on over to Twitter, @HaydockOA. And I'll leave it there. I think 5 minutes is long enough from me. 5 minutes of uninterrupted KP. God bless you for watching it. But don't forget to like, share and subscribe. As I say, hopefully Dave will be back for commentary on Saturday. And we'll see you then.